Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Today, and hope you're having a great time. Today we're back with four interesting updates. Commencing with a Starship update, we'll move to NASA's realignment of astronauts. Then we'll discuss the delay in Falcon Heavy's upcoming flight. We'll end with updates about a Chinese company's future plans of space tourism. Let's begin with an interesting Starship update, where SpaceX gets delivery of hardware for their first 33-engine Super Heavy booster. While preparations regarding the upcoming orbital Starship flight are going on, SpaceX teams are also working on the future prototypes of ship and booster. As a recent addition to their Starbase facility, SpaceX teams got a delivery of booster hardware on the 5th of October, Tuesday. According to a report, they got a delivery of a giant coin-like structure. It seems that this structure is actually a thrust puck for their first 33-engine Super Heavy booster. It's not revealed from which one of SpaceX's factories this delivery of pad hardware has come. Report states that SpaceX can get this delivery either from their main factory in Hawthorne or from their smaller assembly site in McGregor. As we know that SpaceX has already planned to increase the number of Raptor engines in Super Heavy from 29 to 33, this new delivery proves an effective step towards that plan. The new delivered thrust puck has 13 Raptor engine hardpoints, which will help in successfully building a 33-engine Super Heavy. Earlier Super Heavy prototypes, including Booster 4, have 29 engines. They've a thrust puck of 9 engines, i.e., it has an outer ring of 8 Raptor engines, along with one Raptor in the middle of the puck. This 9-engine puck, together with an outer skirt of 20 Raptor engines, completed the 29-engine booster. Report says that the thrust puck, delivered in last week, was in the earlier pattern, and here the recently delivered puck brings up some significant changes. In mid-2021, Musk had stated that a new thrust puck is under development for 33-engine Super Heavy. He says that this new thrust puck featured an outer ring of 10 Raptor engines, along with a group of 3 Raptors in the center. And nearly 3.5 months from this statement, SpaceX got the first delivery of that new thrust puck. It's further larger than the earlier one. In the Falcon rockets, they used an octaweb structure to secure components together with numerous structural parts. But both for Starship and Super Heavy, they looked for a gigantic thrust puck. Now this 13-engine puck, along with the 20-engine outer ring, will successfully complete the 33-engine Super Heavy. In Starship, the central thrust puck, which can support 3 gimballing Raptor engines, has a diameter of nearly 2.5 meters, and it's basically conical in shape. But in Super Heavy, we can see the thrust puck has a flat structure with a diameter of nearly 6 meters and thickness varying between 3 to 4 inches. SpaceX at present is using first-generation Raptor engines. Thus, with these first-gen 33 engines, Super Heavy can produce a thrust of about 13.5 million pound force during liftoff. And sources state that once second-gen Raptor engines come into service, then Super Heavy will produce a thrust liftoff of 16.8 million pound force, which is 3.8 million pound force more than the first-gen Raptors. There's a little chance that SpaceX may use this thrust puck for only testing purposes and may not use it for building a complete Super Heavy booster. In our next update, we'll see that NASA reassigns some astronauts from Starliner to SpaceX Crew Dragon. According to some recent reports, NASA has reassigned 2 astronauts to launch aboard a SpaceX Crew Dragon who were earlier planned to launch on Boeing's Starliner capsule. Due to continuous delays in Starliner tests and developments, NASA has already started to reassign the astronauts from Starliner to Crew Dragon. A report says that those astronauts will launch on a Crew Dragon mission, Crew 5, in August 2022, who will get a chance to get to space in less than a year. Otherwise, if they wait for Starliner, they may have to wait for 2 or more years. With these, SpaceX will effectively manage to complete 5 Crew Dragon missions to the space station ahead of Starliner's first Crew Dragon. crewed flight in future. In 2019, SpaceX's Crew Dragon has successfully completed its debut flight. Besides a failure in the Dragon during ground testing, SpaceX completed Demo 1 and Demo 2 missions successfully, giving them easy tickets for NASA crew launches. But during the first orbital flight test in 2019, Boeing's Starliner faced major software and technical failure during the test, and this delayed it to start for NASA missions. In mid-2021, Boeing scheduled another orbital flight test. But this test also got a major setback as several issues cropped up in the valves of the Starliner capsule. These problems now may delay the Starliner orbital flight test for several months, ultimately delaying the crewed flight test. Thus, NASA chose SpaceX to carry on with the program. Now, let's move to our next update about SpaceX's Falcon Heavy's delayed flight. For another instance this year, SpaceX's next Falcon Heavy launch has been delayed. Due to some issues with a U.S. military payload, it seems like the launch will take place no sooner than next year. The U.S. Air Force, USSF 44, contracted SpaceX in February 2019 to launch a Falcon Heavy rocket. The dates went on being delayed repeatedly. When SpaceX was fully ready and delivered all three Falcon Heavy boosters, even then, USSF 44 delayed the date to Q2 2021. After slipping the date of October 2021, one of the military officers dropped another hint on how USSF 44 is shifting to Q4 in order to accommodate payload readiness. Looking into the military's ambiguous set of words, we can roughly come to a conclusion that the manufacturer under whom the USSF 44's classified payloads are being built face some issues. This issue is basically leading the delay. Spaceflight now highlighted the scenario, saying, "The next flight of SpaceX's Falcon Heavy rocket, previously scheduled for this month, has been pushed back to early 2022 after more delays caused by its U.S. military payload, according to a Space Force spokesperson." As per this official comment, USSF 44 has pushed Falcon Heavy's launch even further, no sooner than early 2022. This delay simply introduces a gap of 30 months between successive Falcon Heavy flights. The last one was back in June 2019. Also, since the launch has shifted to early 2022, the number of important flights in the first half of the year looks quite promising. SpaceX now stands with four upcoming Falcon Heavy missions: USSF 44, USSF 52, Viasat 3, NASA's Psych probe, and USSF 67. Along with the Falcon Heavy missions, SpaceX also has some Crew and Cargo Dragon launches scheduled next year. All these demand the use of the Kennedy Space Center LC-39A pad. There are no less than six launches already scheduled: AX-1 in February, Crew-4 in April, CRS-25 in May, AX-2 in Q3, QRS-26 in September, and Crew-5 in October. Considering both Falcon Heavy and Dragon missions, SpaceX has almost 11 launches in hand for 2022. And all these require the 39A launching pad. Given that the company managed to execute everything as planned, the year will prove to be remarkable. Now we have to wait for more months before Falcon Heavy makes its next flight in the upcoming year. Let's now move on to our final update about China's CSA's upcoming targets of introducing space tourism in 2024. CAS Space, which is a commercial spin-off from the Chinese Academy of Sciences, is developing rockets. The aim of the company is to send tourists on a space tour as early as 2024. They're working such that their rocket can take almost seven passengers on a 10-minute ride. The ride will probably be above the Kármán line, the boundary between our atmosphere and outer space. The designs are somewhat similar to both Blue Origin's New Shepard and SpaceX's Crew Dragon. CAS Space, however, unlike Blue Origin's rocket, is going to include five Zhenyan kerosene liquid oxygen engines. The rocket will be caught by an arm attached to the launch tower instead of landing legs. This concept is very likely to be used by SpaceX. The CAS plans to demonstrate their flight in 2022, followed by a full suborbital test flight in 2023, and finally the suborbital tourism services will begin in 2024. Though the plans seem ambitious, we should keep in mind that CAS Space is well-funded and has support along with expertise that will pave its way toward its goal. The company is China's National Academy for Natural Sciences. It's trying to secure its position in China's blooming commercial space sector. It's leveraging CAS technologies in various areas. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comments section. This will help us to improve.